Welcome back, SWAC fans, to the Cricket Wireless SWAC Women's Basketball Virtual Media Day for the 2020-21 season. I'm your host, James Verrett, and now we travel to the state of Mississippi to Alcorn on the plains of the Natchez Trace. We're joined by head coach Nate Kilbert. And coach, it seems as though you can always go back home again, and this is something that's been almost 30 years in the making.
How does it feel to be back on the plains of the Natchez Trace?
Man, I'm so excited. I'm happy. I'm ready for some basketball. It just feels good being on Alcorn State campus. You know, dealing with this pandemic is just so tough now because we haven't been had a chance to actually train our kids like we would want to. We're doing a lot of film watching now. But just to be back on campus and have the opportunity to know that one day we're going to get it started. And when that green light come on, we're going to be ready to go.
Talking about COVID-19, when you stepped away from the game, the whole world was completely different. And now you step in, it's like you went, you know, like Buck Rogers, you went to a whole nother century. How has this affected the way that you coach and you communicate and interact with your players?
Well, it's a whole different ball game now, the way you deal with the student athlete, because here at Alcorn, the main thing that we're trying to do is make sure that our student athletes stay safe. Like I told you before, we haven't done any training as a team. We've done a lot of individual meetings. We have encouraged our kids to go outside and train to prepare for when we do start training. But it's just been tough, you know, especially for me, who's a new coach, dealing with a bunch of new kids who don't know me and I really don't know them. So I've been doing a lot of film watching from last year games and trying to see how can I help these kids improve. And I think that's the biggest and the toughest thing about coming back to Alcorn now and dealing with the pandemic. It's just a tough time, but we're going to get through it. We're going to find a way that we can help these kids improve. Because I know the reason why Brave Nation brought me back here is to find a way to win championships and to find a way to get this program back to where it used to be. And I'm excited about that.
Your time away from the game, what did you learn? What are you bringing to the table that a lot of people wouldn't expect Coach Kilbert to do?
Well, you know, having the opportunity just to sit out and actually go to the ball games and be a fan, that I think really helped me because, you know, when you're a coach, a lot of times you don't see things from the way fans see it. You don't get the opportunity to get that view of the game. I had an opportunity to get that different view and to see a lot of things as a coach. I won't change a lot, but the way I deal with this generation probably would be totally different. You know, my biggest thing with this group, dealing with the individual meetings and stuff, is trying to find out how do you want to be coached? You know, a lot of them want you all in their face. A lot of them want you screaming at them. Some of them want that. You know, so me sitting on the sideline watching our kids react to coaches and the way they are being coached really helped me to kind of deal with this generation and deal with the way I'm going to approach coaching from here on out. And I think I've done a pretty good job over the years because, you know, it's hard to be in this game for as long as I've been in it, you know. Mm-hmm. I think if you talk to most of my kids, they'll tell you that I was a pretty good coach and I treated them fairly. And I did the things that was most important when it came to them. They was the most important thing when it came to my program. And I think I'm going to do a lot of that coming back, but sitting on that sideline as a fan, you know, it actually taught me something. I enjoyed it, you know, and I'm glad to be back though. And I'm excited about some of the things that we think we can put in place for Alcorn State women's basketball team.
Step away from basketball a little bit. State of Mississippi was front and center because people were demanding, and they've been demanding for years, to change the flag. How important is it, not only for yourself, but all of your players and everyone at Alcorn, to go out and vote to finally get something that some people said would never happen, actually happen and change the flag?
Well, I think the biggest thing is for all the teams, you know, not just at Alcorn, but make sure your kids are registered to vote. You know, that's in our meeting with our kids, we were making sure that all of them were registered to vote. You know, they can go out and vote for who they want to vote for, but our job as coaches to me was to make sure that they was at least registered to vote because it's very important. I mean, what this young generation is saying, they're not going to stand for anything. And they're standing up, you know. And in the past, you know, a lot of us, we just couldn't do that. The law didn't allow us to do that during those times. I say standing up, but they're not going to sit down for what's going on in this world. And that's a great thing, but it started with voting.
Voting initiative passes to change the flag. How is that going to change the state of Mississippi and how student athletes look at schools within the state of Mississippi?
I think it's huge. It's huge simply because, you know, what that flag stood for. You know, I think it hurt a lot of schools. It hurt the state of Mississippi itself. A lot of people didn't want to bring business to the state of Mississippi because of that flag. I think now we'll start to get more businesses to come in. And that means more jobs for the state of Mississippi. You'll start seeing more kids actually coming to school in the state of Mississippi. So I think it was huge that the flag was removed. It should have been done a long time ago, you know, but it happened. And that's the most important thing. It was done. It was done at a good time, I think, simply because now it's time for the business to start booming. Once we get past this pandemic, I think you're going to see Mississippi grow in a lot of areas when it comes to development.
All right, Coach. Thank you so very much for your time and good luck to you right there on the reservation.
James, appreciate you, man.
We're joined now by Alcorn State student athlete LaRae Rascoe. And Ms. Rascoe, first of all, how has life changed with all of the COVID-19 protocols?
I wouldn't say it changes a lot, just stops a lot, you know, with everything going on with practice, basketball, you know, a season, you know, everything just like that, adapting to it. I mean, it got to happen. You got to go through it. So just got to get used to it. Got to adapt to it.
Let's talk about that shirt that you have on. What does all of those words represent and what does that mean to you?
Accomplish all goals. Adjust to the players around you, adjust to everybody else's ability to do different things. Adapt to everybody around you. Adapt to what everybody else can do.
What are your first impressions of your new coach, Coach Kilbert?
Coach Kilbert seems like a good coach. He's not really, I haven't really got to sit and really, like, you know, meet and talk yet with everything going on, but seems like a good coach.
Okay. We had a chance to talk to him and he says that he wants to see you shoot the ball more. Do you think that offensively that's something that you want to do and put that on your shoulders?
Yeah, definitely.
How does that make you adjust your game as far as preparing to have the load offensively on your back?
I wouldn't say like it's a big load or it's like a big, you know, it's not like a big thing to like accomplish or anything. Just doing it, not thinking about it and just doing it.
Okay. What are your expectations this season for your squad?
Just to be better than we was last year.
Okay. You go up against a lot of teams that are much taller. Is that a challenge that you wish you had more taller people, or do you embrace that and say size doesn't matter because we can outshoot you?
I'm going to go 50 and 50, but more so it doesn't matter. I mean, the faster you are, I feel like the better you are. The taller you are, the slower you are.
As far as this year's squad, as far as improving upon last year, what's the one thing statistically that this team needs to do in order to let everyone else know and let yourselves know that you're a better team outside of wins and losses?
Boxing out or rebounding.
Well, good. Thank you so very much.
Thank you.